அல்ஹம்துலில்லாஹ் அஷ்ஹது அல்லா இல்லாஹ இல்லல்லாஹ் வஹ்தஹு லா ஷரீக லஹு ப்ரைஸ் பி டு காட் தெர் இஸ் நோ அதர் காட் பிசைட் ஹிம். இன்ஷா அல்லாஹ் டுடேஸ் த டைட்டில் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டாக் அபவுட் இஸ் ஷஹாதா. ஸோ வாட் இஸ் ஷஹாதா, லைக் வாட் இஸ் த மீனிங் ஆஃப் ஷஹாதா? ஷஹாதா மீனிங் த ப்ரொக்ளமேஷன் ஆஃப் ஃபெய்த் பேரிங் விட்னஸ். லைக் அஸ் ஹியூமன் பீயிங் இட் இஸ் மேண்டட்டரி ஃபார் அஸ் டு டிக்ளேர் அவர் ஃபெய்த், அண்ட் தட் இஸ் வாட் ஷஹாதா. வி ஹாவ் டு டிக்ளேர் அவர் ஃபெய்த், ப்ரொக்ளைம், வி ஹாவ் டு ப்ரொக்ளைம் அவர் ஃபெய்த் தட் வி ஆர் பிலீவர்ஸ் இன் காட். ஸோ வாட் இஸ் கரெக்ட் ஷஹாதா? அஸ் பெர் குரான், காட் டீச்சர்ஸ் அஸ் இன் சூரா 3:18. The correct shahada is La ilaha illallah, which is Arabic La ilaha illallah. In English, this meaning is there is no God except God. So, which means that God is telling us that to declare, as believers should declare that there is no other God beside God. Like there is only one God. That is the core meaning of this. And God says that God bears witness that there is no God except He, and so do the angels, those who possess knowledge. Truthfully and equitably, He is the absolute God. There is no God but He, the Almighty, Most Wise. The Shahada, proclamation of faith, is the same first commandment given to Moses, and it has to be the same commandment given to all the prophets and messengers. So this is what given to Moses as per Deuteronomy chapter 5:6. I, the Lord, am your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery. You shall not have any other God besides me. Like, we all know the story, like in Egypt, like Moses people were been they are taken as slave, and they have been given hard labor and all these things. We know the struggle they came across, and it is explained in Quran in detail in Moses story. So God is saying the same thing, that that shahada is mentioned in what was given to Moses, and this is what God is saying: you shall not have any other God besides me. So God is the only one God, and there should not be any subordinate or anyone equal to God. So why need to declare shahada? To prove ourselves and declare our faith, submission to God, by saying correct shahada. Can we add any other name in shahada even if it is true? Like for example, like we will go in detail about this. Like, the true believers know that, like, the story behind why we are saying that no one writes to alter God's word. Like, because God is saying that the shahada is La ilaha illallah only. If we add anyone's name, like in tradition, Muslims say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulillah shahada, which is contradicting with God's word, which the message is being same to Moses and even to Prophet Muhammad as well. In the Quran, God says La ilaha illallah is your shahada, as per Surah 3, as we have seen earlier, Surah 3:18. La ilaha illallah is your shahada. So if we add Muhammadur Rasulillah, even though the Muhammad is a Rasulillah, but it is not required. It should not be added along with shahada as the declaration of faith. So true believers know that Muhammad was the messenger of God and bear witness that La ilaha illallah, there is no other God besides God. So by saying La ilaha illallah alone, it doesn't mean that we are rejecting Prophet Muhammad or any as such thing. Like, we know that we believe that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God, and through him only the Quran was revealed, and we believe that 100%. But when it comes to shahada, it should be la ilaha illallah only, as per Quran. So surah 4 verse 36, you shall worship God alone, do not associate anything with him. Like, we know the meaning of associate. Like, if we add anything or any source or any imam, or even if it is Prophet Muhammad also, we should not associate along with God. The God is the one, and the believers should declare that la ilaha illallah alone as shahada. Surah 22 verse 31, you shall maintain your devotion absolutely to God alone. Anyone who sets up any idol beside God is like one who fell from the sky, then gets snatched up by the vultures or blown away by the wind into a deep ravine. So here, anyone who sets up any idol beside God, like idol is, doesn't mean that here it is not limited to any statue or a such thing. The idol is something that even like if you don't have that visually as statue or something, the idol is something, believing something that other than God can help you, other than God we need to please, like all these things comes under idol worship. So God is saying that Surah 22 verse 31, our devotion should be absolutely to God alone. Anyone who sets up any idol beside God is like, God is giving the example, the like anyone like fell from the sky, gets snatched up by the vultures or blown by the wind into a deep ravine. And then Surah 39 verse 3, absolutely the religion shall be devoted to God alone. Those who set up idol beside him say, we idolize them only to bring us closer to God, for they are in a better position. God will judge them regarding their disputes. God does not guide such liars, disbelievers. God is saying that in Surah 39 verse 3, anyone who's saying that those who set up idols beside him say, we idolize them only to bring us closer to God, for they are in a better position. Like if we as the traditional Muslim who say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah as shahada, the most common hadith which says that if we say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, on the day of judgment Prophet Muhammad will be talking on our side in front of God to take us to heaven. So this is what here God is saying. These are the liars and disbelievers who says this. We idolize them only to bring us closer to God, for they are in the better position. God will judge them regarding the dispute. God does not guide such liars, disbelievers. Then Surah 39 verse 45. When God alone is mentioned, the hearts of those who do not believe in the hereafter sink with aversion. But when others are mentioned beside him, they become satisfied. So like if we as I have experienced in common, like whenever we say la ilaha illallah, the traditional people will get upset or they will get angry and start to argue with us, like why you are not adding Prophet Muhammad's name, or why you are rejecting him. It doesn't mean that we are rejecting Prophet Muhammad. We believe that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God, and Quran is been revealed through Prophet Muhammad by God's leave. It doesn't mean that we are rejecting him, but God is saying God alone should be mentioned, and if we are adding anyone's name beside him, like those disbelievers are satisfied by adding others' name beside him. What this verse clearly giving us the message is that only God alone should be the shahada, and we should not listen to such disbelievers. And they are like, they will stink with aversion, like they are not satisfied by saying la ilaha illallah alone. They will always add la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah as their shahada, because they are thinking that Prophet Muhammad will take them closer to God, which is never true as per Quran. So, Surah 40 verse 12. This is because when God alone was advocated, you disbelieved. But when others were mentioned beside him, you believed. Therefore, God's judgment has been issued. He is the most high, the great. The same message what was given in 39:45, the same essence of message is being given in 40 verse 40, Surah 40 verse 12 as well. The true believers know that Muhammad was the messenger of God and bear witness that La ilaha illallah is the Shahada. There is no God beside him. Like true believers, like true Muslim believe that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God. Of course, he is. He was at the same time, our Shahada should be La ilaha illallah. We should be very clear on this part. A gross blasphemy. Many Muslims insist on adding Muhammad's name to Shahada, which we have discussed earlier. Many Muslims insist on adding Muhammad's name in the Shahada, defying God and the idea of keeping religion absolutely to God alone. Nowhere in the Quran can we, we can find that Muhammad's name added to the name of God in the Shahada. The statement Muhammad Rasulullah is the statement of fact and should not be confused with the statement of Shahada that we bear witness. However, the Quran's great creation in Surah 39 verse 45, sorry, the Quran great criterion in Surah 39 verse 45 stumps such are disbelievers that we seen that these are the disbelievers. Surah 39:45. And these people are the disbelievers and these are the liars which God is saying. Surah 39:45 stumps the such are the disbelievers. When God alone is mentioned, the hearts of those who do not believe in the hereafter sink with aversion, but when others are mentioned with him, they become satisfied. This is the important statement of fact that when others are mentioned beside God, they are satisfied. In Surah, the hypocrites, Al Munafikun, in this Surah, verse 1 says that when hypocrites come to you, they say, this is the message to Prophet Muhammad. God is saying that when the hypocrites come to you, they say, we bear witness that you are the messenger of God. God knows that you are the messenger, you are his messenger, and God bears witness that the hypocrites are liars. So those people, those hypocrites come to Prophet Muhammad and trying to please him, thinking that he may take them closer so that it will benefit them. So which is not the fact, but God is saying that God bear witness that these people are the hypocrites and these are the liars. There is an indication that mentioning of Prophet Muhammad's name as the messenger of God next to God to the Shahada of Shahada, that is of the hypocrite Shahada. Saying La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah is the Shahada of hypocrites. Thus, those who recite Shahada adding Muhammad's name as the messenger of God belong to the hypocrites. But it is unfortunate that the majority of Muslims ignore this fact and insist on mentioning Muhammad is the messenger of God in the Shahada precisely stated by God in Quran as well as in the previous scripture. Previous scripture is that we know that Injil, Deuteronomy and all these things. Even in the oldest scripture also, nowhere in the scripture like adding the messenger or prophet's name along with God's name is not given. Only God alone, La ilaha illallah, the same meaning only given in throughout all the previous scriptures as well. Since this is the religion of Abraham, as per Surah 2, 130 and Surah 2, 135, Surah 3, 95, Surah 4, 1, verse 125, Surah 6, verse 161, Surah 12, verse 37, 38 and Surah 16, 123. And Surah 22 verse 78. In all these places, God is saying the only creed must be La ilaha illallah, there is no other God except the one God. Muhammad did not exist on earth before Abraham. Like this is what God is saying, that Islam is the religion of Abraham, really, like the name submitters, Muslims, itself given by Abraham. So even Prophet Muhammad is God. In one verse, God says to Prophet Muhammad, follow the religion of Abraham. That is why the all the like the religious rites like Shahada, Salat and all these things were given to Prophet Abraham, and yeah, that is what God may, that is what the same instruction was given to Prophet Muhammad, to follow the religion of Abraham. So since the religion, like Islam is the religion of, since the religion of Abraham, it is no way to say that we cannot justify by saying that La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah is the correct shahada for the Muslims, because Abraham lived like a few thousand years prior to Prophet Muhammad's time. So in the sense that the core message is that La ilaha illallah is the correct shahada. So no distinction among God's messenger. So God says in Quran that there should not be any distinction among God's messengers. Like we say, like after Prophet Muhammad only our the whole generation of Muslims are here, so we have to, us, we are through him only we got the message of Islam, so we are the follower of Prophet Muhammad, and that is why we need to add his name, and all these things cannot be justified, as the religion itself came from through Abraham, and even Prophet Muhammad was instructed to follow the religion of Abraham. So Surah 2 verse 136 say, we believe in God and in what was sent down to us and in what was sent down to Abraham, Ismail, Isaac, Jacob and patriarchs, and in what was given to Moses and Jesus and all the prophets from their Lord. We make no distinction among any of them. To him alone we are submitters. Surah 2 verse 136, which is in Quran, God mentioned, we know that Quran given to revealed through Prophet Muhammad, and through Prophet Muhammad's words only God is revealing that we make no distinction among any of them. So we are not allowed to take any differentiating, like he is closer to me and I am the follower of Prophet Muhammad, like that we cannot say. We should not make any distinction among God's messengers. So that is what the core message given in Surah 2 verse 136. Surah 2 verse 285, the messengers have believed in what was sent down to him from his Lord, and so did the believers. They believe in God, his angels, his scripture and his messenger. Like believing in angels, scripture and messenger doesn't mean that we have to add messengers in shahada. It doesn't mean that. We make no distinction among any of his messengers. Like God is saying that we should not make any distinction among God's messengers. Have we ever say La ilaha illallah Isa Rasulullah or La ilaha illallah Musa Rasulullah? Why we are always in a way promoting La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, Muhammad Rasulullah everywhere? Like God is giving us the clear command here that we should not make any distinction among God's messenger. And they say, we hear and we obey, forgive us our Lord, to you is the ultimate destiny. This is what the statement of the believers. Again, I will read this verse. The messengers have believed in what was sent down to him from his Lord, and so did the believers. They believe in God, his angels, his scripture and his messengers. And these believers will say, we make no distinction among any of his messengers. They say, we hear and we obey, forgive us our Lord, to you is the ultimate destiny. So this is what the should be the statement of Muslims, the as the believer of God, we should not make any distinction among God's messengers. And if we are making any distinction within God's messenger by saying La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, this is the clear indication of distinction. So we should not say that. And as earlier we have seen, these are those people who are all saying that La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah as their shahada, and they are trying to justify it, and God saying that these are the hypocrites and liars. We need to be very careful on this part, inshallah. Surah 3 verse 84, say we believe in God and in what was sent down to us and in what was sent down to Abraham. Oh, this is what we have read, well, the same verse been copied. So the same statement in given in Surah 3 verse 84 as well. Say, God is advising the believers to say it, declare it. We believe in God and in what was sent down to us and what was sent down to Abraham, Ismail, Isaac, Jacob and patriarchs, and in what was given to Moses, Jesus and prophets from their Lord. We make no distinction among any of them. To him alone we are submitters. So then Surah 4 verse 150, those who disbelieve in God and His messenger and seek to make distinction among God and His messengers and say we believe in some and reject some and wish to follow the path in between. So this will be the statement of the disbelievers. They say they seek to make the distinction among God and His messengers, and they say that we believe in some and reject some. That is why earlier I have said that we never in, if we ask any traditional Muslim, never in their life they say La ilaha illallah Isa Rasulullah or La ilaha illallah Musa Rasulullah. They will always stick with La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. But I am not saying that La ilaha illallah Isa Rasulullah should be the shahada. No, La ilaha illallah is the shahada for all, like since the beginning of the creation, like only that should be the shahada. The point is that the traditional people, traditional Muslim, they are saying that by adding Prophet Muhammad's name, it will take them closer to God, and God is advising us everywhere we should not make any distinction among the messengers. And they say that we believe in some and reject some. This is the point again, why they are saying that La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah alone means they are rejecting the other, are they rejecting the other messengers? So this should be the question we have to ask ourselves when we say when we say that La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah shahada. Here we are taking Muhammad Rasulullah closer and rejecting the other messengers. This should not be it is contradicting with we should not make any distinction among the messengers. Surah 4 verse 151, these are the real disbelievers. Surah 4 150 says that, and they make distinction and they believe in some and reject some, and God is saying that Surah 4 in verse 151, the next subsequent verse, God is saying that these are the real disbelievers. We have preferred we have prepared for the disbelievers a shameful retribution. Like we need to be very careful that God is saying that these people who are all saying making distinction among the messengers of God, these are the real disbelievers, and for this disbeliever God has prepared for them the shameful retribution. The next verse again, as for those who believe God and His messenger and make no distinction among them, He will grant them their recompense. God is forgiver, most merciful. MashaAllah. After knowing this truth, if we leave out the traditional beliefs of saying La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah as shahada, we start to say La ilaha illallah as the shahada, and we have stick with what is the teaching given in Quran alone, then God is forgiver, most merciful. MashaAllah. Now we will go on to the mathematical confirmation, which we in the previous video we already discussed about the 19 mathematical miracle, which is giving us the confirmation that the Quran is the word of God, and there is no way to no way for any person or anyone to duplicate Quran, or they can add anything to the Quran. Because as per the, because of this, mashallah, with this mathematical, this awesome miracle, we will say, with this miracle, we can prove that Quran is the word of God. So through this mathematical confirmation, again, we can confirm that the real shahada is La ilaha illallah. Inshallah, we will see in detail now. So this is La ilaha illallah in Arabic. And as we have said earlier, each Arabic letters have that grammatical value. They call it abjad value, abjad number. So during the time when the Quran was revealed, during that time there is no such numbers as 1 2 3 4 5 6 as we use now. In those time, even for trade and any transaction or any counting, they use Arabic letters as numbers. Like each Arabic letter have its unique value. That you can just Google abjad value or Arabic grammatical value, you will get the details, and you can find it on Wikipedia and many other sources as well. So as per the real shahada, La ilaha illallah, as per this Arabic letters, these are all the value of the the letters, like lam, lam 30, value is 30, and then alif value is 1, and then again alif values 1. Likewise, if you put the numbers, so the grammatical value of these letters associated with them are all these numbers 30, 1, 1, 30, 5, and all these numbers are written here. Now, if we write this number all together, which is multiple of 19, if we write these numbers all together, next, which gives the output, the number is the multiple of 19, which is written here. If we write the numbers 30 1 1 30, as Arabic is from right to left, it starts from here to here, and then we will write the numbers as per this one, 30 1 1 1. Likewise, if we write here, and this huge number which is multiple of 19 by this many times, this you can verify it with the with the help of computer. Mathematical confirmation is the stamp of God on this statement, clearly indicating to us that this is the correct statement, and this amazing stamp leaves no doubt about our shahada, mashallah. Because see, God is being most gracious and most merciful to us, and he is giving us the proof in all the directions. We have seen that in previously in Quran verse, various Quran verse and different angle, God is saying that our shahada should be La ilaha illallah alone. And God knows that in future, after Prophet Muhammad, people will add Prophet Muhammad's name into the shahada. So that is why God mentioned in the Quran that we should not make any distinction among God's messenger. In the Quran only God has mentioned this. And as Muslims, we read Quran almost every day, and we still insist on saying La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah Shahada, which is the clear indication that those who say such thing are the real disbelievers, and these are the real disbelievers, we can say. But this is very hard fact that God is being most gracious, and he is ready to redeem us anytime. So we should leave out everything else and follow the strict straight path, which is Quran alone, and which is indicating such thing. And even he is giving us the proof through this mathematical confirmation that La ilaha illallah is the shahada. So there are five instances, wahdahu alone, which is the wahdahu, the meaning of this word wahdahu, Arabic word means alone, which refer to God, are found in surah, in four surahs. The word wahdahu, when it is mentioned about God, like God alone, in such a way, in four surahs it has been mentioned. If the relevant surah number and the verse number are added, the sum is the multiple of 19. So here it is, surah 7 verse 70, the Wahdahu was mentioned, so they added up to 77. Surah 39 verse 45, the total comes to 84. Then surah 40 verse 12, in the surah 40, in two different verses the word Wahdahu attributing to God alone is mentioned. So surah 40 verse 12 and 84 comes to total 136, and then surah 60 verse 4 total comes to 64. If you add these numbers, total comes to 361, which is 19 times 19. Mashallah, this proof we can see it in this screenshot here. The word Wahdahu mentioned, well, like where and all it is mentioned, like this screenshot. Hope it is clear and visible to you. This you can verify it by yourself also. Like, as God is giving us the instruction in Quran, without verifying with clear mind of belief, like without verifying anything, we should not be accept it. So we always advise you to verify it by yourself by looking at the Quran text and verifying, yes, this is what mentioned, like that will give the real essence of belief and real essence of the God's message. Inshallah, hope you all verify it by yourself and start to believe, declare our real shahada. So this most important expression, La ilaha illallahu, there is no other God beside him, occurs in 19 surahs. In total 19 surahs, the word La ilaha illallah is mentioned. Mashallah, again the number 19 comes here. Also, by adding the number of 19 surahs where La ilaha illallah occurs, plus the verse number where this crucial expression is found, plus the total number of occurrences, which is 29 times, the grand total comes to 2128, which is 19 times 112. Just the alignment is just mixed up here. This is the surah number, this is verse number, and this is the total occurrence. So surah 2 verse 163, one time mentioned, and then same in surah 2 verse 255, one time mentioned. Likewise, if we put where and all this La ilaha illallahu mentioned, if we count each and every occurrences, total comes to this number. The surah total is 507, and then the verse count comes to 1592, and the total number of occurrence La ilaha illallahu is 29. If we add this total, the grand total comes to 2128, which is again 19 times 112. Like, you can verify it by opening your Quran and verify it by yourself, inshallah, please. So the first occurrence is in surah 2 verse 163, and the last occurrence is in surah 73 verse 9. The total sum of numbers plus the number of verse in between the first occurrence and the last occurrence plus the sum of verse numbers is the total comes to, we will see in the detail, total comes to 316502, which is 19 times 16658. So here it is. So likewise, if we count the overall up to the last occurrence, which is 73.9, which is mentioned here, till the last occurrence, if you count this this huge number, so total is 2700, and then 5312, and then this one 308490. The total comes to this number 316502, which is again 19 times 16658. This mathematical analysis of God alone, Allahu Wahdahu, exactly tells us that the association of anything or anyone with God from his creation would be idolatry. So we know that the idol worship means that not the statue or going to a synagogue or a temple or church. We know idol worship is something other than God can help you, or adding any other name along with God is what the idol worship is. Hence, there should not be any doubt in the hearts of true believers that the correct statement of faith is, there is no God beside God. In Arabic, La ilaha illallah. So, praise be to God. That's the end of the video now. So, the overall, the summary, the point is that our Shahada should be La ilaha illallah, and we have given the Quran proof. The earlier we have discussed, mentioned like all these verses where La ilaha illallah alone mentioned, and where God is saying that we should not add anyone's name beside God, and God is giving us the warning that those who add anyone's name beside God are the disbelievers, and these are all the like by adding, by saying that Muhammad Rasulullah along with Sahada, which is the indication of the hypocrites, God is saying that. So, all these verses and all this mathematical calculation, and we advise everyone to verify it by yourself. We have mentioned that this verse says like this, means like you should open your Quran, and if you know Arabic, you can read like if you know the meaning of Arabic, you can straight away read it in Arabic, or if you, and if you are if you don't know Arabic and your language is different, you can easily get the translation of Quran in the language, like in the any language you can understand, and even in English translation also available. Like anyway, you can verify it that what this Quran verse says as per the Quran you are holding in your hand, and you can verify it, and by verifying only you will come to the real strong faith that this is the real Shahada, La ilaha illallah. And also we advise you to go through this mathematical calculation, which is really like mind blowing, which is like it takes time to note down everything and summarize it, but it really worth. And if you do this, and if you count and each and every number whatever we mentioned, and you can just verify it at least, like okay, whether like we said that Surah 7 verse 70 means, you can verify it where Surah 7 verse 70 really says that or not. In such a way you can verify it, and you can count it by yourself, and then you will have no doubt on Shahada, that La ilaha illallah is the true Shahada. So that's all for now. Inshallah, we will, God willing, we will come up with more videos in future. Alhamdulillah, inshallah. Thank you.